loads on the bubble and strive to stay alive. Got a 4-5 on me. At all times, I do this shit to the death for real. Now part-time, the general. Push nothing but hard lines. It'd be your funeral. Nigga, fuck you with me and mine. Too many Indians, not enough chiefs. Too many enemies, not enough beef. You heard me? Check it. Preach to these niggas for a second. Open up your ears and watch out for the blessed. Be true to the game and it'll be true to you. But now you get damn failed and it'll be cruel. The zoo, we don't buy by guidelines. We on the field active. We don't do sidelines.
Hello, world. All my kings and queens, especially the Zooligan tribe. Thank you all for stopping by and hanging out with me. It's another beautiful day above ground. Another day for us to find a way out of the mazes and pitfalls that they set for us to fail. 24 hours in a day. One thing that everybody, every human being have on earth in common. How we utilize that 24 hours is the difference in making success and not making success. Idle time, that's the enemy. Well, what's idle time? Idle time is watching football, watching baseball, watching basketball, watching Netflix and Hulu. All that is idle time. Hanging out with the homeboys and homegirls, smoking and drinking, talking about nothing. Nothing that's gonna help us and assist us to being better. Now, if the conversation changes and we start to engage in conversation that's gonna help to build us to be better, well then, that's the difference, man. Now, before I go through four, you know I gotta send a shout out to the Father and bring God into the building. But before I do that, I wanna say one more thing. And then I want y'all to tune in to the homeboy on the latest and greatest that Planet Zoo Entertainment has to offer. My homeboys and homegirls in Southeast San Diego, I don't wanna hear nothing about it not being any qualified participants and helping and assisting y'all to be better and greater. Like y'all don't have nobody to look up to. You see everybody on that wall right there? All them in Southeast San Diego, greats, legends that done made it out of Southeast. So I don't want to hear about what you cannot do. You can be better than us. You can strive for greatness. All you have to do is put your best foot forward and mash 100. The same way we mash about this bull crap that we stuck in. You gotta mash even harder on the gridiron if you want it, because you can have it. Just look at this. Those are the people that you need to look up to and idolize. Those are the people that's gonna help you to be better. God first, read your Bible. Now, I am the Honorable King Onaje Gates, the boy Barbie. Born and raised in Southeast San Diego, on the east side in the Skyline District. I, through God, have found my way up out of the mazes and pitfalls that they set forth for us to fail. I have been in that system we call jail, making these people who runs it millions of dollars for multiple years. And I'm talking about from my juvenile all the way up to my adult. I didn't get out till my 30s without snitching, without telling, without degrading myself. I stayed tall like a man. I got in the game like a man, and I got out the game like one. All through God's help and mercy. And I hope to assist you guys doing the same, and maybe you can find your way about it again. Now, check this out.
Yeah. Down E line and all that. This way. Look. Watch how I make it happen. They gon' think it's magic. shit these haters gonna think is tragic. Stitch tightest in my fabric. And every time I slide up Trey 5, it be nostalgic. Young nigga, married to this game, this shit romantic. Shit ain't go as planned, but still end up how he planned it. Praying that I fail, my dog crossed me like a Catholic. Trying to run it up, gotta avoid that asthmatic. Long runs, it's all gonna pay off in the long run. Got the Benz washed and took the foot to get her toes done. Charge it like a proton. I got the blood of a dope gun, I wish a nigga would. I got court, but my lawyer said he gon' go for me, it's good. The thought patterns of the misunderstood. They killed PT, that shit woke me. They killed my brother, that shit broke me. Thinking about the game, looking at my trophies. Told her I'ma change the world, she tryna be my one and only. Moms told me detectives came looking for me. Shit, this hurt my heart to have to see her worry, cause I'm the last son she got. Last one she got, and I told her I'ma buy that mansion for her, just watch. And I love my pops, even though we ain't in a good spot. Came at me sideways like a hook shot. Hey, I ain't mad at him, nigga always looked out. He ain't leaving, Babylon's took him out. Yeah, money in the drawer, but I need more. Had her catching dates, took her on tour. Numerology, give me 70 on 4. And sucker shit is something I never be known for. And they're like, if you don't pull up to the set day, you done for. The way I make it happen, they gon' think it's magic. Shit. Yeah. The way I make it happen, they gon' think it's magic. They gon' think it's magic. Hey, they gon' think it's magic. Hey, they gon' think it's magic. Voila, they gon' think it's magic.
Thank you, Lord Father, for allowing us to come together in your name. For Lord Father, thank you for all the blessings that you rained down on me. Thank you for opening up my mind so that I can see you clearly. Please, I beg you to help those that's lost find their way. I beg you to help them to understand that you do forgive, that you do love, and that you are waiting with open arms to bring them out of harm's way and to sheltering arms. Because in your wings is where all is protected, and no harm can come to them. Please, thank you for blessing my friends, my foes, my enemies, and my family, and continue to rebuke the devil, evildoers, and bad spirits against us and ours, Lord Father, and help us to be better men and women to our young and to ourselves and to those around us. Help us, Lord Father, to uplift the streets and the ghettos and the boroughs and the blocks in which we hang, Lord Father, so that we can have a better place for our babies to grow up in. Lord Father, in your name, all things is possible. I just love Jesus Christ and my God, man. Through him, all things is possible, man. Without him, I wouldn't know nothing about freedom. Hey. And I'm talking about here.
Yeah, yeah.
It starts there, not just here. I appreciate all the love you've given me. My mental awareness, I got a big brother by the name of Little Boo. I talk about him often. I look up to him. I was, in a way, raised by him because I wanted to be just like him. I mimicked him. I emulated him to to the fullest and utmost to getting that girl to trying to fight. And he, as strong as he was as a kid, found his way into the darkness. And not me, not nobody that I know yet have been able to get him a back. And that just, like I said, makes me understand how much, how blessed I am. It's not luck. It's blessed to have my mind, to be able to create and keep striving for greatness, keep knocking down different goals and chapters and steadily grinding and moving. And I want the same for y'all. My Zulianette that come through and bless. Thank you, Lord Father, for utilizing these beautiful souls as vessels to help and assist me push you to the forefront so that everybody can see you shine through ever so bright. All is appreciated, love. All my kings and queens, you can be better. Anyway, I want to talk about 5-9 Brands. It's a neighborhood in Southeast San Diego who I have a lot of respect and honor and love. As a kid, I used to steal cars with a little dude named Jungle Jim, and I had a homeboy, rest in peace, named Sue. Jerome Bronson, and through him, I got a part of Black Moose. Black Moose, I love you, man. I pray that you and yours is doing good, being real blessing, being real blessed. I used to hang with these guys real tough, man, in my adolescent years, stealing cars. Me and Black Moose have a better report than Jungle Jim, still yet. I still want to give a shout out to you and yours, my homeboy D-Nut. Thank you for tapping in with me, loved one. I got nothing but love for you and my boy Daybo. And if y'all don't know Daybo, he's a man. He's a soldier, man. He was funny, man. He's a comedian. He used to keep me laughing, man. He kept the jokes. he looked like an old gremlin to me. You know what I'm saying? The Professor Gremlin. But anyway, a good dude, man. And those that do know him, stop by, holla at your boy, man. Make him smile, man. Take him out, do something good for him, because it's not always about us, but the love that we give out, and maybe that might help somebody else be better, right? That's what it's about, loving others, and then reciprocating that. 5-9 Brands, again, my partners, man, some good dudes. A lot of good dudes come from there. I also smoked Sherman in the basement with my big homeboy, Ronald Rush. Rest in peace, you know what I'm saying? I used to slide through here with him. And I wouldn't really get as wet as he would, but still yet, I used to hang out around them areas a little bit. So now, this story is about them. 1993, they had a picnic. Now, back then, in them days, man, we would go to Fam Bam and get fresh, you know what I'm saying? All the homies, all the homegirls, you know what I'm saying? You either get the airbrush or you get the letters on the back, right? I would get the letters on the back of my shirt, right? You know, black shirt with red letters, red shirt with black letters, you know what I'm saying? Have my khaki texture crease, a brand new flag, you know what I'm saying? Crease that thing up and make sure I was on super duper fly, you know what I'm saying? Because it was all about representing. And back then, all the neighborhoods would come to that picnic. I'm talking about the Diamond neighborhoods. We would come to that picnic and we would have a damn good time. You know what I'm saying? And it was vice versa. Come to our hood, go to Emerald Hills and such and such, right? But like I said, 1993 was right after they started implementing the three strikes law, right? And so a lot of our G's was gone. You know what I mean? And so the tide started to turn around in this era. And this happened to be my era. So I'm really like the last generation that had the essence of the love between our communities before it started going awry. Before I go too far on that, I do have to give a shout out to Gangsta Earn and the entire Gangsta Earn family, because that was my big homeboy. No, I never met him, never shook his hand, none of that. But reason why he's so symbolic and instrumental to me in my life, because he was the first funeral that I ever went to, family, friend, or anything. I went there to pay my respects, but also to look death in the face, because I knew that this was the lifestyle that I was gonna be a part of, and I wanted to see how it is. And once I did that, I was able to switch my mind to Vietnam, so to speak. You're here today, gone tomorrow. So any relationship that I did have with my homeboys, I really didn't get too tight with. Even if I did, I was still able to, you know, kind of like when they gone, that's just life, man. You know what I'm saying? And so I was able to deal with it without it leading me to drugs and so on and so forth, like a lot of people. A lot of people never got over certain loved ones that passed. And like I said before, that's why his funeral and he is so instrumental to me. Now, back to the Brim Picnic. We go to Skyline and Meadowbrook, me and a couple of homeboys. We went about 10 carloads deep. At this time, a lot of y'all cats were still in school and whatnot. Y'all couldn't come out. You know what I'm talking about? So a lot of y'all ain't gonna remember this story that I'm talking about. Remember, me and my family, the Barbies, we had dropped out of school in junior high. Seventh grade, we had dropped out. Eighth grade, I was gone. You know what I'm saying? We were still going every now and then, but by eighth grade, I was gone. School was nonchalant, you know what I mean? So anyway, we go to Skyline Park, 10 carloads deep, we match. The picnic is at J Street Pier by the beach. The day is kind of gloomy. To me, the weather, that was perfect. Around the time, about 12, 1 o'clock, I want to say. It might be a little early, maybe about 11. Anyhow, as soon as we park and get out and start mobbing up in there, one of them twins was hanging at the gate, right? I don't know if it was Mick and Nick, but he was faded already, right? And he was sad tripping, you know what I'm saying? And the reason why I say sad tripping, he has a bandana on his face. All I seen was the eyes, but I know the eyes because I know the twins, you know what I'm saying? I didn't been in their company enough. I was in juvenile hall with one of them, so I was kind of able to see. You know what I'm saying? I knew enough anyway. So while we coming in, he bang on. 5'9", brown, you know, Skyline, Eastside, 5-0, you know what I'm saying? Bang back, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, the me mug and all that is there. I mean, the aggression is there, you know what I'm saying? On his side and on our side. So really, we already know, you know what I'm saying? It's festivities, right? Get up in there, first person I see over there with the brim hanging by the DJ table is my boy Montreal Park, you know what I'm saying? And he's by himself, though. Ain't nobody else Montreal there at this time that I remember. But next thing I noticed, Lincoln Park. Lincoln Park is up in the building, right? And then I see Emerald Hills in the building. Now, only reason I seen Emerald Hills is in it, I seen it was there, but the reason why I really took notice of them being there is because my older relative, shout out to Scott Hammond. I looked up to him, man. He was hard on that gridiron, man. He had all the girls, you know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying? He's a fly guy. So, of course, when I see him, he's the first dude I'm pushing up on, you know what I'm saying? But I'm really tripping off, because I'm definitely slightly faded, but I'm coherent enough to where I'm paying attention. And that was one of the things with me that I always did, was stay paying attention. I never got too faded, especially if I wasn't in home base, you know what I'm saying? So when I see him, he just, you know, he's staring at me. I think he was tripping on me, I don't know. But he see me, I'm banging, I got the flag in my back pocket all the way down to the ground. I got the Eastside Pyro on the back of my shirt. I got the hat with Baby Boo and Skyline on it. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just, you know, I'm active, you know what I'm saying? And I'm tripping off him, he tripping off me. And while I'm talking to him, the fine iron brim started tripping on emerald. I don't know why. But all of a sudden, the Emerald Hill, the whole crowd is moving. You know what I'm saying? And they're going from over here to over here. And I don't know what's happening, but all I know is the South is tripping on them, right? And I don't know how many of the brim was tripping on them, but I do know that whoever it was, they was moving the crowd, right? And while that's going on, boom, a fade jump off between my cut, Big Ben. You know what I'm saying? That's my boy. You know what I'm saying? So when he started showing him, I'm trying to get the mix. She's grabbing with Sam Bam from Lincoln Park. Sam Bam, rest in peace, I believe. I don't honestly know, but I believe he's resting in peace. And they squabbling on me, you know what I'm saying? It's going down right there in the middle of the thing. The crowd, and you know, crowd swarming. I'm trying to get in the mix. My big homeboy, hey, Fred, like, hey, you know what I'm saying? Because now if I get in the mix, it's going to change everything to a whole nother thing. So they finally break them up. Once they break them up, now, you know, like shocks, man. The blood is in the wallet. You know what I'm saying? Lincoln Park, they want a little bit, you know what I'm saying? They ready, you know what I mean? We ready, you know what I'm saying? And start turning up. But you got to remember, this is a 5'9 Rams picnic. So no matter what, we shockwaving their picnic. Oh, yeah, also, the police is definitely there. Let's not forget them. All the homies is there. All I'm saying, all the different hoods in Southeast. But also, not Bloods. But also, the police is in the building for sure. So when that happens, automatically, man, that's going to throw off the whole function. You know what I mean? So, A-Frey, being a real big homie, like Jesus supposed to do, instead of just saying, you know, just go, you know, let's tear up their picnic like dumbasses, he got us all together and was like, look here, man, this is the brim day. This is their picnic, blood. We up here throwing off their whole little mojo. Now, we can stay here and tear this mug up, or we can be the real ones, you know what I'm saying, and get on, man, you know what I'm saying, and let them have their day. You know what I'm saying? And take it back to the Skyline Park, since we already got a lot of females, a lot of homies, you know what I'm saying? You know, the mix is on. We got drink, we got smoke, you know what I'm saying? It's a good time already. So let's go ahead and bust a move. That's what we did. We jumped in the car, you left, went back to Skyline Park, you know what I'm saying? And towed that up, hung out around there, went up to Skyline and Meadowbrook. And I believe later on it was a party. Then after that, some Bomb to Pie Rules came down to hang, you know what I'm saying? Met up on us at Moonlight Market. And it was a good time, you know what I'm saying? And that's how we used to stop the bull crap back then. And that takes real G's, like I said. But once they gone, all the rules out of the building, then it's chaos. So anyway, that's how that picnic went for us. I don't know how it continued for the South and Emerald and everybody like that, but while I was there, that's what occurred. Had a good time, man. I want to give a shout out, like I said before, to all my gremlins. Nothing but love and respect. And with that being said, I want y'all to stay safe. Stay reading your Bible. Stand out instead of standing in. Standing in ain't gonna get you noticed by no one. You have to stand out. Stand outside the crowd. Even if you gotta wear yellow. You know what I'm saying? You gotta blend out, not blend in. Anyway, I wanna give y'all one more little nugget before I go. Remember when Jesus came in hand, he kicked it with thugs, the drunkards, prostitutes, gangsters. And when he spoke to the people, he said, I am the light, and through me, all those who believe shall inherit the light as well. To come out of darkness. It's all for you. You are leaders of men. You are soldiers. You are the epitome of what a king and a queen look like. Let no one deter you yourself and the things that you can achieve while on this earth. Yes, you might start at a disadvantage, but now they have this thing called the internet. Guess what? Loaded with information where they can't deny you wisdom, knowledge. You just have to seek. And once you seek it, believe in it. And you will achieve it. Throw it out to the universe. God hear you. I promise. Be behind the door, shaking hands and whispering in ears. Just believe and have faith. That's where that comes in. With that being said, I want to say, I love y'all and stay up. And again, read your mind. Don't forget to log in and subscribe, like, share, and comment. Oh, buy that book, baby. That will help this channel greatly. 5-Star General, Volume 1, Cali Bangin', written by me. Available on Amazon. Also, we got a soundtrack coming your way. We got mini movie coming your way. And I got Volume 2, Street Marine, 5-Star General. Hey, baby, we working.
Takers and thieves, cops and robbers, but we playing for keeps. Straight out the mud, gotta make it look clean. Get the loot from the troops, I'm a street marine. I'm with the jackers and flockers. Takers and thieves, cops and robbers, but we playing for keeps. Straight out the mud, but I make it look clean. Get the loot from the troops, I'm a street marine.
Based off, play soft, get chased off. Loud tall me, I flash the burner and take off. Hey, we can block it if the money right. And go sliding on the same night. Quick, I'm over the fence and through the window. Unlock the door for the homies to enter. Now, street marines always coming with tactics. We lick your house and use the weapons we jack with. So, hold the line, we done started a war. Black ops, fuck the cops, soldier, run up the score. Send a scout team, have them run us the coordinates. Knock them down, let them know that we ordered it. Taking over shit, taxing everybody serving it. And I bet you never heard of this. No. Loose lips don't fly around here. Street treason is a crime, you'll die around here. We 5-star generals and they kill admirals. Planet zoo shit, bitch, we the wild animals. Jackers and blockers, takers and thieves.